cold and so dark cloudy out here. Looks like it could rain any second, but hopefully it doesn't. All right, what's going on today? I thought this was kind of fascinating. It basically relates with things like drone regulations, how people perceive it, whether or not it makes sense. And a lot of people who actually fly the drones, or even things like a model aircraft, would say it's completely over the top. It doesn't make sense. It just restricts people from doing something safe they've been doing for years. And it doesn't even focus on safety when you think about it. As evident, some people have been crashing their drones, like here in Canada, the police actually crashing their drones into helicopters, so obviously something's wrong, correct? So to me, it's fascinating to understand why is it that certain people support over-the-top regulations that don't make sense. Is it because they're misinformed, for example? They're not really educated about the topic, which would make sense. Or are they just selfish, where they want to commercialize everything and they don't care? For example, a person who flies it recreationally is just going to be the victim of the process. They need to do that for them to create their business or whatever. Now, why I was thinking about this today is because for some of my old videos, it seems like some people have just seen them for the first time. And they're basically, I suppose you could say, very supportive of Transport Canada or drone regulations with the way they are. And they're trying to tell me, for example, they think it's fine. And I'm basically in the wrong, if that's the right way to say it. And in some cases, I just leave it there because I'm fascinated to see how many people would actually latch on to that comment. And in some cases, I actually give them the facts to see, okay, let me see how you actually deal with stuff like this when I'm telling you this is how it is. That's not how things would be run in other aspects of life. In many cases, they either, one, just delete their comments, which to me is like, what? Or two, they actually just attack me personally. So I guess it's kind of an interesting study in that way. So you can kind of see the psychological aspect of this for any historian that wants to come back in time in the future to see how it was like. Now keep in mind, in some cases, I don't know if these people are just trolling to be funny, but it makes you wonder. So for some context, here is like a comment that revolves around me saying the questions on those exams here in Canada, a lot of them make absolutely no sense. It doesn't relate to a drone operator. It's about regular airplanes, for example. It doesn't make people safe. That's what the focus should be, correct? On safe flying. So this person here, from what I gather, I think he's a traditional manned aircraft pilot. So read this. He says here, the opening and closing shots on your video shows why the need to take test. How high was your drone in those shots? Were you below the maximum height you are allowed to fly? Were you able to see your drone at those heights? The test is not to make you safer. It is to teach you that you need to keep out of my airspace to keep me safer. At the height you are flying, you are in a very real chance of doing damage to me if I am legally flying in that area. The entitlement in this message here, it makes me think this guy is 100% selfish in my opinion. Maybe a bit of cultural ignorance too. I mean, what height am I flying at? How do I know? It tells me everything on the screen. I mean, do you not know that as a traditional pilot and how modern day drones are like, especially these ones? I mean, in this case, if you are flying as low as I am and you're flying a manned aircraft, it's not what am I doing up there this low, it's what are you doing down here, in my opinion. And doesn't anyone else think that's weird what this guy implies here? The test isn't to make you safer? Isn't that the whole point of doing like a test like that? And ultimately, this isn't what they teach you in that thing. They don't teach you the basics, for example. They teach you very ridiculous and over-the-top stuff in many cases. For example, clouds. For a basic operator, how do you operate in this controlled airspace, for example, when technically you shouldn't be in there, period? So there, to me, it doesn't make sense. It just comes down to, in my opinion, this guy's selfish. And that's my opinion, but you can interpret it as well. Like, what would you think? Now this one, I think it's about cultural ignorance in the sense of maybe this guy is not fully aware of what I guess a quote drone is in classification here. Like it affects so many other different people. For example, model aircraft, they technically bundled everything in the same bucket. One example that I use as an analogy was a lot of those questions on the test is almost like someone going for their driver's license and you're asking them questions about a train, which doesn't make sense. So in that sense, in this guy, he kind of uses the train analogy, but I think it's really flawed, and I'll explain. This guy here says, well, actually, when we fly a drone, we are using Canadian airspace. There are rules and regulations and procedures on using Canadian airspace, and historically, that's manned aircraft pilots' knowledge. Those questions are legit, in my opinion. is not like a car driver answering questions about trains. It's more like driving your car on the railway. Sounds stupid, but that's pretty much what we're doing with our drones. And are not being able to communicate with the train drivers and not knowing train rules. So there's a flaw in the analogy there, because to imply these regulations or a drone operator, it's kind of like a car riding right on the train tracks. To use that example appropriately, it has to be kind of one-to-one. So that means you're implying that a drone operator, for example, is going right into the airport, flying at the exact same height and path of an airplane. You're saying that's common, what people are doing. That's not the case. People don't do that, the majority of people. So that doesn't make sense in that way with this person trying to use that train analogy. If you think about it, cars go by train tracks every single day. I'll use like a map here, like one in the Vancouver area. Look at that train track. Cars drive past it every single day. Do they need to understand things, for example, regulations on how a train operates, how to contact the train operator? They don't. What it comes down to is basic traffic management. They develop a system where if a train's coming, they're gonna put these things here, these signs, etc., etc., these lights. It warns you, stop, let the train pass. How ridiculous is that? If a car driver had to learn everything about a train there to, quote, communicate with the train operator. Now, has there been cars that actually drive right into the train track? I bet there has been, but that's on a case-by-case basis, correct? Doesn't that make sense? That's how it should be with a drone operator too? If they're flying right inside an airplane at the same height, for example, 2,000 feet or whatever, then yeah, they should be punished separately. But to make everyone learn stuff that's not related to them in that way, to me, it's ridiculous. It doesn't really focus on safety at all. Again, it depends on how you're using it, because you don't do this in any other aspect of life. And he goes on saying, there are chances of accidental contacts with other manned aircrafts, and a regulation or law's job is to minimize the chance by providing procedures. Airspace is more controlled because consequences of an accident is higher than those on the road. You need to know how a real pilot uses the airspace, just like if you were allowed to use RC cars on the road, you need to know the traffic rules. Do you think RC cars should be allowed on the roads? Probably most road users, vehicle drivers, would say no to it. The fact that drones can be legally operated is pretty much a privilege. $10 exam fee and retry after 24 hours only encourage you to learn all the knowledge you need to know. I don't know why people are saying the government just wants money. In my opinion, as an immigrant, I find the Canadian government rather responsible and diligent. Now, there are plenty of different points to cover there, which when you think about it, it doesn't make sense, because even with using this example with cars on a road, that's not how it's done here. For example, again, if something happens like that, someone riding an RC car on the road, it's an isolated incident. They take care of it. Stick with the road example here. How many different things use the road? For example, a person on a bicycle, they're actually literally on the same road, but they're on different paths, correct? They don't need a driver's license. They just need their own set of guidelines, common sense. They're not gonna drive right in the middle of a busy highway in front of the other cars back to back as if they're a motorcycle. A pedestrian that uses the road, basically just across the street, there's a light there to tell them, okay, it's my turn. Like there, it comes down to traffic management. You don't make a pedestrian learn everything that a car driver needs to learn. Why do they need to know that? In my opinion, like here, this person says he thinks the government is doing a fantastic job. I think that's laziness. You don't want to take the time to develop the basic traffic management system. If you're afraid about airplanes, they should not be this low, period. Just like a car, if a car drives into the sidewalk, that should be their fault. That's common sense. Whereas right now, it's their airspace. Who's going up there? Like the majority of people. I don't think the majority of people are flying 1,000 feet in the air or something like that. Even here, if it's someone flying recreationally, like a huge airplane, they should theoretically be like, what, 500 feet in the air? Why are they here? It should be pretty simple. You stay on your side, we stay on ours. Doesn't need to be complicated. Now with this, I would say this message is probably a bit more about cultural ignorance. You don't really understand the whole picture. Like I can see this guy here, he's coming more from a perspective of a DJI drone. He's not thinking of things like a model aircraft person, for example. That's what I get the impression personally here. Because when you don't really understand the topic as a whole, then you can't really use analogies effectively and accurately like here. Because if you think about it, you use the road, it's not managed the way it is like here, the way it's managed with the test and all that. Because like here, you could be someone that flies drones too, but because you're not fully aware of what everything means in the big picture, you're kind of blind as to how it affects other people, if that makes sense. Now, in cases like those, I actually don't reply because I'm kind of fascinated. Let's see how many people actually latch onto that, even though, as I kind of demonstrated, it doesn't really make sense. Even when you think about it with your own example, that's not how things are done, and people would probably be outraged if it is. But sometimes I do reply to it because I'm interested in kind of pushing it a little further, saying, let's see how you really respond when you're made to think. So in this example here, it relates to the topic on how potentially Transport Canada wants to introduce potentially more regulations for things like sub 250 gram drones. And I think a lot of people would say, no, you stay away from that. Like, you have no business doing that. Just be safe, correct? Like, that should be the bottom line. So this guy, in response to that, he writes here, generally speaking, thanks, but man, you have the wrong attitude. I noticed in an earlier video I saw of yours, you got your advanced certificate from a pretty generous flight reviewer. Good for you. But RPAS involves so much more than just a man and a tiny aircraft. They share airspace with manned flight aircraft, and so it's reasonable that to maintain the highest level of safety, all persons using the airspace have the same information. It's like piloting a boat. Ships and dinghies share the water. I don't know what a dinghy is, I don't ride boats. It says, even to run a tiny outboard or jet ski, you need to be licensed. On a boat, everything has a very specific meaning. Hopefully the captain or pilot knows all the indicators and all issues can be dealt with safely for everyone's health and happiness. There are more things to know about in the air. Not everyone is flying in a remote forest or pasture, but someone who did all their flying there could show up in sophisticated urban airspace and attempt to fly without much more consideration. As with everything, the more you know, the better off you are. The better off you are, the general public at large. I think Transport Canada is doing a very good job of laying out the rules. Cops and officers are also good at giving out fines. Just do it. Respect your relationships. Thanks for the pointers. So from this guy's opinion, it sounds like he's saying it makes sense for everyone to have to know these types of information, so to speak, because it's that same example where their perspective is you're sharing the airspace. Versus like myself, I'm saying, you're sharing the airspace in a completely different way, just like in the road. So in my example here, I use his example of the water. And when you think about it, it actually isn't run the way this airspace regulation and stuff is actually when you think about it. So I said here, is it my attitude or your perspective that is off base in regards to comprehending the point of view and why people like that flight reviewer encourages a person like me in actually calling out laws that currently don't make sense to make it more accessible for people and to actually focus on safety issues as opposed to fear mongering that affects people flying in, say, a remote forest, as you say? Or how about someone flying in their backyard of their house below the tree height? I even told him, you can even watch an old stakeholder session I recorded where Transport Canada representatives couldn't really answer that when someone asked other than a quote, oh well, if it affects them type of mentality. So I used his example of things like the sea and the water. I said, I'll use your boat example. Think of how many people or things share the water. Does a person surfing need a boating license? How about a regular average people that swim in the water? In my opinion, you are not looking at the whole picture and how it affects everyone with how they use it, which is the ironic part with what you wrote. Do you think a kid playing with an RC toy boat should need a boating license too? The world does not revolve around, say, DJI drones or large airplanes. Example, model aircraft people are hit by this too, where they have been doing this hobby for decades. Just like with the water, it doesn't just revolve exclusively around boats and jet skis. Or do you think someone riding a canoe at a local lake needs a boating license as well? That's a fair question, isn't it? I mean, you're using the water as an example comparison to the airspace, how I guess like this guy's saying every boat in that sense needs to be regulated and to be safe. That's not how it works. It depends on what you use, because you can ride things like a canoe. You don't need a boating license for that. For example, they're completely different with how they use it and where. And I basically ended it by saying, Transport Canada would never dare to write laws like that in categories that affects the mass majority with topics the average person can relate with versus the still niche topic of drones. Generally speaking, like everything else in life, such as the road, it's about traffic management. You don't manage pedestrians on foot or bicycle riders like a car driver that needs a driver's license. Likewise, you shouldn't manage people flying small, quote, drones that are far away from large planes and their paths as if they are the same thing, using the airspace in the exact same way. Like everything else in life, it should come down to what you're using and how. So I was actually fascinated to see, okay, let's see how this guy responds to it, because like in the other ones, I didn't actually reply to them, whereas this one I did. Let's just see how these guys really think. And once you know it, the person just deletes their comment. With that example there, I can imagine if that guy's whole world in his head is just, hey, these boats, these motorized boats, cruise ships or ferries or whatever, that's his restriction in terms of what a boat is or what uses the water, then yeah, I can perfectly see why you form this kind of opinion. It makes you wonder, like there, whether or not it's cultural ignorance in terms of things like drones and how people use it overall or the airspace in general. You have to think overall how it affects everybody. Because when you think about it and you try to compare it with other things in life, like what a lot of these people do, that's not how it's run. So it makes you wonder, is there a solution for that? And again, it'll be interesting for people who look back in history on what the mindset and mentality was in general. All right, see you guys later.